New York cowbell.
Guess
time.
What?
What?
I got a fever. And the only prescription is more
cowbell.
Everything litty, y'all love when it's hot.
More cowbell. SNL. You guys have been wanting me to do this more cowbell for a minute now. What's going on with it? I think I did, what song was it? What song was it? I did a song. Damn it. Oh, please don't fear the reaper. I got that memory. I can't believe I remembered it. It was a minute ago. Please don't fear the reaper. And it had that doop, 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 doop. Ever since then, everybody said, we need you to do more cowbell, SNL, more cowbell, SNL. I'm here. I'm here, guys. Follow me on everything in the description. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Merchandise is in the description as well. It's different links. More cowbell, SNL. What's going on with this? Come on.
Series of staggering defeats, Blue Oyster Cult assembled in the recording studio in 1976 for a session with famed producer Bruce Dickinson. And luckily for us, the cameras were rolling.
All right, guys, I think we're ready to lay this first track down. By the way, my name is Bruce Dickinson. Yes, the Bruce Dickinson. And I gotta tell you, fellas,
damn it, what's his name?
What appears to be a dynamite sound.
He a famous
coming
actor.
From you, Bruce, that means a lot.
Yeah, I mean, you're Bruce.
Oh, that's Seth Rogen. Seth Rogen? Damn it. What's his name, y'all? I'm not getting his name wrong. I'm sorry, man. Damn it, what's his name? More cowbell. I'm going to just put it in a... Will Ferrell. That's Will Ferrell. Will Ferrell, you look a little chubby, man. What's going on, Will? Man? Will.
Bruce, that means a lot.
Yeah, I mean, you're Bruce Dickinson.
This is incredible. I can't believe Bruce Dickinson digs our sound.
Easy, guys. I put my pants on, just like the rest of you, one leg at a time. Except, once my pants are on, I make gold records. All right, here we go. Fear, don't fear the reaper. Take one, roll it.
Fear, don't fear the reaper.
One, two, three, four.
Oh, that's the actual song. No, I'm sorry. You're not about to tell me that's how this song was made. Will Ferrell hitting a goddamn cowbell? Is this real, guys? No. Oh my God.
Could you come in here for a second, please?
Why is that so funny?
That was going to be a great track,
Why
guys.
Why is that so damn deal? Funny,
are
man?
Are you sure that was sounding okay?
I'll be honest, fellas, it was sounding great, but I could have used a little more cowbell.
Hey, that's enough cowbell. Yes, I'm going to be pausing it a lot, y'all. I'm tired of skimming through, you know, all the dang on skits and stuff and not really getting full enjoyment. He was smacking the hell out of that cowbell. How much more do you need, Dickerson?
Cowbell.
So, let's take it again. And Gene.
Yeah.
Really explore the studio space this time.
You got it, Bruce.
I mean, really.
Yeah.
Explore the space.
Okay.
I like what I'm hearing. Roll it.
One, two, three, four.
Boy, you shut up! Stop!
Hi, could you come back in there, please? Fellas, we just wasted two good tracks.
Guys,
this last one was even better than the first. Well, it's just that I find Gene's cowbell playing distracted.
Why is this so
good? I don't know. If I'm the only one, I'll shut up.
No, it's pretty rough.
You know, I can pull it back a little if you like.
Not too much, though. I'm telling you, fellas, you're gonna want that cowbell on the track.
You know what? It's fine. Let's just do the thing.
Hey, roll it. 1, 2, 3, 4.
That beginning riff is beautiful.
Come on, Jim!
No,
come on!
That
it doesn't work for me. I gotta have more cowbell.
Don't blow this for us, Gene!
Could be so selfish, Gene.
Can I just say one thing?
Yeah, baby, just say it.
I'm standing here staring at rock legend Bruce Dickinson.
The cock and a walk, baby.
And if Bruce Dickinson wants more cowbell, we should probably give him more cowbell.
Say, baby.
And listen
to Bobby, you are right. I am being selfish. But the last time I checked, we don't have a whole lot of songs that feature the cowbell.
I gotta have more cowbell, baby.
And I'd be doing myself a disservice and every member of this band if I didn't perform the hell out of this.
Do your cowbell.
Guess
time.
What?
What?
I got a fever. And the only prescription is more
cowbell.
Thank you, Bruce.
Dude, pull your shirt down.
If I just leave and maybe I'll come back later and we can lay down the cowbell.
Come on, baby.
Gene, wait. Why don't you lay down that cowbell right now? With us. Together.
Damn. Yeah. Do it.
Do you mean that, Eric?
Yeah. He speaks for all of us.
Thank you.
Babies.
Okay, guys, I'm sorry to pause it again, but is this the real Blue Oyster Cult band? Or is this, you know, SNL known for spoofing a lot of stuff. I don't know if this is the real Blue Oyster Cult. If it is, they dope as shit. They dope as hell.
Before we're done here, y'all be wearing gold-plated diapers.
What does that mean?
Never question Bruce Dickinson. Roll it.
Roll it. Let's get it.
1, 2, 3, 4.
I only paused it because, you know, music will block the video. So I was trying to pause in between the little music because that's the real song. That's the real Blue Oyster Cult song. In memory of Gene Franklin. I can't read. I even got glasses on. Call myself even being able to see better. And I see. I think I'm dyslexic, y'all. I think that's what it really is. Gene Frankel, 1950 to 2000. He lived a long life. He lived a good life, man. In memoriam of Gene Frankel, 1950 to 2000. Well, guys, I'm on my way to get a Rosetta Stone, learn how to read before I come back to the video. Hey, Will Ferrell is funny as crap. I haven't watched a lot of his. I think I've watched one Will Ferrell movie. That's why I had to look him. I knew it was. Guys, I got a lot of catching up to do, honestly. I need to get into a lot of Will Ferrell. Will, you know I got the movie channel. Any Will Ferrell movies I should get into, or I gotta learn, I gotta do a lot more back stuff. Because now that I'm starting YouTube, it's like, damn, I could get into everything that I never liked before and people are interested in it. I would have never listened to Blue Oyster Cult. an amazing song if I didn't touch YouTube platform. I'm sorry. I would have never seen More Cowbell if I haven't touched the YouTube platform. It's just the God honest truth. I'm happy I touched this platform. I got to listen to Dire Straits, AC/DC. Some of these bands I'm listening to is legendary. The Beastie Boys, I got hip to them. I would have never got hip to this stuff. Thank you, YouTube. Thank you, subscribers. You guys lead me in the right direction. Any more cowbell? Until next time.